Hi students, welcome to Smart IQ online classes. This is Ekavira. So today we are discussing some very interesting problems on inverse trigonometric functions. This is a very important topic as far as JEE mains is concerned, right? So let us see some problems. So let us see the first problem. This is the first problem. If x is sine inverse sine 10 and y is cos inverse of cos 10, then we need to find the value of y minus x. Please remember, whenever you are getting questions of this sort, like something like this, sin inverse of sin x, okay, cos inverse of cos of x, all these, tan inverse of tan x, all these, you have to be thorough with graphs of these functions. If you are thorough with the graphs of these functions, you will be able to solve these kind of problems. So please go through the NCERT textbook to go through the graphs of these functions, analyze the graphs of these functions if you have any doubt in the process of listening to this video. Okay, so now let us solve this problem. X is sine inverse of sine 10. So the graph of sine inverse of sine 10 is this. Basically, if you consider a function f of x is sine inverse of sine x, sine inverse of sine x is a periodic function with fundamental period 2 pi and whose graph is this. So this is the graph of sine inverse of sine x. So it will be like this, right? So this is 0, at this it is pi by 2, and what is the sine inverse maximum value, principal range? Pi by 2. So this is pi by 2, this is minus pi by 2, this negative side is minus pi by 2. This is pi x axis, so it cuts x axis at 0, pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, multiples of pi. So this is 2 pi, and then this is 3 pi, and so on. So it will go off, right? So this is the graph of sine inverse of sine x. This problem, these kind of problems, sine inverse of sine, cos inverse of cos, can be easily solved using graphs. So once you are thorough with these graphs, you can solve any problem given in this format, right? Now, actually, what is the value of x given? It is sine inverse sine 10. What is 10? 10 is basically radians, not degrees. It's not 10 degrees, it's 10 radians. Be careful in reading the question. They didn't put the symbol like this, 10, that is 10 degrees. They didn't put that. So since they didn't put that, it is treated as a normal number. What do you mean by normal number? It is in radians, okay? So 10 radians. What is the value of pi in radians? It is 3.14 approximately. And what is 3 pi? 3 pi will be something like 9 point something. So basically, mathematically, if you compare 3 pi and 10, 3 pi is less than 10. Okay. So there is a 3 pi in this graph. So 10 is somewhere above 3 pi, but not for too much distance, because 10 minus 3 pi is very, very small. Approximately 0 point something you will get, okay? So it is not 0, it is 0 point something. So 3 pi is just, 10 is just above 3 pi. Now, we need to calculate sine inverse of sine 10. If you observe from the graph, what is sine inverse of sine 3 pi? 0 obviously, because it is cutting x axis at 3 pi, right? Sine inverse of sine 3 pi is 0. But how to calculate sine inverse of sine 10? Now it is very important to find the equation of this straight line. So let me continue in the next slide. That equation, which is like this and which is cutting the x-axis at 3 pi, when the line is like this in this direction, the slope is negative. So the equation is given by 3 pi minus x. But what is x value here? According to the equation, x value is how much? 10. So x is 10 here. So please substitute 10 here now. So my x value in the question given is, that is sine inverse of sine 10 is equal to, according to the straight line, it is 3 pi minus how much? 10. So this is the value of x given in the problem. So sine inverse sine 10, that means somewhere here it is how much you got? 3 pi minus 10, which is obviously negative. That you can easily see from the graph. for 10, if you just draw a vertical line, it is taking a negative y coordinate. So negative y coordinate, and what is the negative y coordinate? It is 3 pi minus 10. So please make a note of this graph. This is the graph of sine inverse sine x, which is periodic with a period, fundamental period 2 pi. Now let us see cos inverse of cos of x graph. So I am just drawing it here. So this is the graph of cos inverse of cos of x, like this. So this is 0, okay, this is pi, this is 2 pi, this is 3 pi, this is 4 pi, and so on. And what is the height? Pi, because cos inverse is always principal range is 0 to pi. So in this topic, you please go through principal range of inverse trigonometric functions, if at all you have a doubt in that, and the graphs of cos inverse of cos, sine inverse of sine, all those things. So if you are thorough with those, you can solve these kind of problems, right? Now, as usual, what is the value of y given? It is cos inverse of cos 10. Cos inverse of cos 10 is basically, again 10 is there. So 10 occurs immediately after 3 pi. So this is 3 pi, right? So 10 is somewhere here. Okay. That means we need to take this straight line. This straight line is also sloping in this direction. So negative slope, and minus 1 is the slope. So what is the equation of that line? 4 pi minus x, but x is how much now? 10. So instead of 3 pi minus, it is 4 pi minus, because it is cutting x axis at 4 pi. Whereas sine inverse sine x is cutting x axis at 3 pi, that is why it is 3 pi minus x. Okay. So it is 4 pi minus 10. So we know y value as 4 pi minus 10, x value as 3 pi minus 10. Just subtract, y minus x is nothing but subtract 4 pi minus 10 minus of 3 pi minus 10. So 10 gets cancelled and pi you get. So this is the answer. This is the best way to solve these kind of questions graphically. Whatever value I give, I'll just compare with pi, 3 pi, 4 pi or whatever. Suppose in the question, you can please try it. The same question, you can try it like this. Suppose x is sine inverse sine 15. Instead of 10, you take 15, and y is cos inverse cos 15. So you please comment it. What is the value of y minus x using this graphical approach? Now it is not 10, it is 15. So which one you will take nearest to the 15? I hope you can guess it. Logically, it should be how much? So please try it, right? So basically, sine inverse of sine x, cos inverse of cos x, tan inverse, secant inverse of secant, all these things, if you know graphs, it's very easy to solve, right? Let us go to the next problem. The next problem is tan inverse y is tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of 2x by 1 minus x square. It's given that mod x is less than 1 by root 3. Then you have to find y in terms of x. The most important formula we have to use in this problem is this one. Tan inverse of A plus tan inverse of B is equal to tan inverse of A plus B by 1 minus AB. This is a very important formula, provided the product of AB is less than 1. This is a very important condition. When this condition is true, then only this formula is valid. Every time if I ask you tan inverse of A plus tan inverse of B, it is always not this. When it is this, when the product of these two numbers is less than 1. Okay. Now, first of all, we start with this condition mod x is less than 1 by root 3. What is the use of this condition? It plays a very important role in this problem. When mod x is less than 1 by root 3, squaring, just square it on both sides, x square is less than 1 by 3. Obviously, when x square is less than 1 by 3, just cross multiply with 3. Remember, inequalities can be cross multiplied with positive numbers. Suppose if it is 1 by x, then you cannot cross multiply unless you know the sign of it. But 3 is positive, right? So you can do that. So 3x square is less than 1. So 3x square is less than 1, you got. So next, what we do is, this can be written as 2x square is less than 1 minus x square, right? This implies 2x into x is less than 1 minus x square. This implies bring 1 minus x square left side, x into 2x by 1 minus x square is less than 1. 1 minus x square is brought left side because 1 minus x square is anyway positive, because x square is less than 1 by 3. Since x square is less than 1 by 3, 1 minus x square will be obviously positive. And since it is a positive quantity, I am just bringing it to the left, inequalities does not alter. What is the use of all these? Why I am doing this? I hope you got some clarity why I am doing this. If you observe the question, x is a. So I am writing here, a is x. And b is 2x by 1 minus x square. Now what is this product? AB, is it not? So I have proved that AB is less than 1. I am able to prove this because of this condition only. If they have not given this, I don't have any idea. We can't solve this problem. We don't have any clue, because this is very important. Even if you give 1 by root 5, yes, we can do this. But this condition is satisfied for 1 by root 3. So what is the specialty of mod x less than 1 by root 3? By manipulating this in this way, so this particular way, I concluded that the product of AB is less than 1. Now I can use this formula. Okay, so let us continue in the next slide. So using that formula, I will get tan inverse of x plus tan inverse of that b. That b is 2x by 1 minus x square. Since the product is less than 1, we can directly apply the formula. It is tan inverse a plus b by 1 minus ab. That is x plus 2x by 1 minus x square divided by 1 minus product. The product is 2x square by 1 minus x square. Simplify in the bracket, then you will get tan inverse. Okay, taking LCM, you will get 3x minus x cube divided by 1 minus 3x square. That's it. But what is given? LHS, tan inverse y. Okay, so this tan inverse of y is same as tan inverse of, okay, 3x minus x cube divided by 1 minus 3x square. Now the question arises, can we cancel tan inverse? Yes, we can. Please make a note, tan of tan inverse theta is theta for all theta belonging to real numbers. But the other way around, tan inverse of tan theta need not be theta. Tan inverse of tan theta, as I told you, there is a graph. Sin inverse of sin theta need not be theta, because the graph is moving up and down because it is periodic. Cos inverse of cos theta need not be theta. So, but cos of cos inverse, sin of sin inverse, tan of tan inverse, all these are theta in their domain, right? So taking tan on both sides, so indirectly if you take tan on both sides, so take tan both sides, then we get tan of tan inverse, which is theta. So y is equal to 3x minus x cube divided by 1 minus 3x square. That's it. So we have found y in terms of x. So what is the application of this problem? What is the simple application of this problem? This formula, tan inverse a plus tan inverse b. You have to use it very, very carefully. So in your book, there are two other formulas of tan inverse of a plus tan inverse of b. It is based on this condition. When ab is greater than 1, when a is negative, b is negative, ab is greater than 1. When a is positive, b is positive, ab is greater than 1. So based on that ab condition only, we can use the formula. Just don't blindly use it, right? Let us see the third problem. The third problem is this. F of x is 2 tan inverse of x is given plus sin inverse of 2x by 1 plus x square. X is greater than 1 given. Then we need to find the value of f of y. Now again comes the graphs of tan inverse tan, sin inverse of sin. The basic formulas that we use it here is this one. Sin 2 theta is 2 tan theta by 1 plus tan square theta. This formula we use. So before, we use the substitution theta is tan inverse of x. This is the first substitution I am using in this problem. Students, please remember, don't use the substitution x is tan theta. This substitution is actually not logical, but this substitution is logical. Theta is tan inverse of x. Reason: inverse trigonometric functions have concept of principal range. Okay, so in your textbook, please go through what is principal range of inverse trigonometric functions. Okay, so theta is tan inverse of x. Obviously, x is greater than 1 given. When x is greater than 1, theta will be belonging to tan inverse 1 to tan inverse infinity, because x is greater than 1. And what is tan inverse of 1? Pi by 4. Tan inverse of infinity is pi by 2 open. So this is the range of theta, because theta is greater than 1. I mean, x is greater than 1. So when x is greater than 1, we have identified that theta is belonging to pi by 4 to pi by 2, right? Now let us substitute in the function. Then I'll get a function, some g of theta, because the function is now in terms of theta. So what you'll get is, again, finally we'll convert back to x. 2 tan inverse x is what? Now if you take tan on both sides here, x is tan theta. So after using this substitution, theta is tan inverse of x, take tan on both sides, then you will get tan theta is equal to tan of tan inverse, as I said, is always x, right? And this is not the correct substitution, because when you use x is tan theta substitution, you don't know what is theta. But when you use theta is tan inverse of x, you know theta, because actually theta belongs to minus pi by 2 to pi by 2, that is the principal range. Okay, so 2 tan inverse of tan theta plus sine inverse of, now what is 2 tan theta by 1 plus tan square? It is sine 2 theta. Now we got tan inverse of tan, sine inverse of sine. Now the graphs, we already know the sine inverse of sine graph. I have discussed in the first question. I am just once again drawing it for the sake of clarity. So it is like this, like this, like this, and like this. It goes on like this, but it is for 2 theta. So this is 0, this is pi by 2, this is pi, and so on. When theta is in this interval, 2 theta will be in which interval? So multiply with 2 here, pi by 2 to pi. Pi by 2 to pi is this straight line. I'm just shading it, pi by 2 to pi. What is the equation of this straight line? It is sloping downward. So its slope is negative minus 1, I mean negative 1. So what is the equation of that line? Y is pi minus x. So sine inverse of sine x is equal to pi minus x. When x is in which interval? This pi by 2 to pi. Okay, so I'm just making a clarity of this. So we'll continue here. I'm just erasing this because I don't have a space here. So now what we have is sine inverse sine 2 theta is equal to pi minus x, that is 2 theta, right? And we know that theta is actually belonging to pi by 4 to pi by 2. Now we have the function g of theta is 2 tan inverse tan theta, is it not, plus sine inverse sine, how much you got? Pi minus 2 theta. Now there is a graph of tan inverse of tan x. So this is the graph of tan inverse of tan x with the discontinuities at pi by 2. So this is 0, this is pi by 2. But we need pi by 4 to pi by 2. Theta is in. So pi by 4 is 45 degrees and pi by 2 is 2. So this part is sloping in this direction. It slope how much? 1. And it is passing through point origin. So what is the equation of this straight line? Y equal to x. So what is tan inverse of tan theta in this interval? Theta. So it is theta, but 2 is multiplied, plus pi minus 2 theta. So cancelling 2 theta, you get pi. So g of theta is pi. It is independent of theta. When g is independent of theta, f will be independent of x. So this implies f of x is pi. That's it. F of x is pi. So f of x is a constant function. When f is a constant function, what is f of pi? Pi. So answer is pi. So basically, these questions are dealing with the graphs of these functions, sine inverse of sine, cos inverse of cos. So don't get confused. If you are thorough with these graphs, I'm damn sure giving you a guarantee that you can solve these problems very easy. Okay. So let us go to last problem. Similar problem. Sine inverse of 2 into 3 power x, the dot is into, that is by 1 plus 9 power x. We need to find the derivative of this function at minus half, f dash at minus half. One method is directly use the differentiation formula. So what is differentiation of sine inverse of x? 1 by root of 1 minus x square and chain rule. That is one method. You will get the answer, no doubt. Let me explain another method. Let theta is tan inverse of 3 power x. Again the substitution. When theta is tan inverse of 3 power x, 3 power x is always greater than 0. Implies theta belongs to 0 to the last is pi by 2, because 3 power x is greater than 0 and 3 power x is less than infinity, right? Maximum 3 power x can take is infinity with open. So tan inverse infinity is pi by 2, tan inverse 0 is 0. So theta is in this interval. What is the use of this substitution? Like previous example we have seen 2 theta by 2 sine theta by, I mean 2 tan theta by 1 plus tan square is what? Sine 2 theta, right? 3 power x, 9 power x. What is 9 power x? 9 power x is 3 power x the whole square. So 2 into 3 power x divided by 1 plus 9 power x is 2 into tan theta, because 3 power x is tan theta, by 1 plus tan square theta, which is sine 2 theta, right? So what is f of x now? F of x is, or in terms of theta you will get now, sine inverse sine 2 theta. Let us use the graph of again sine inverse sine 2 theta. So I am just using it here, sine inverse of sine 2 theta, or I will draw it again. So this is the graph of sine inverse sine. It is like this, like this, like this, like this. But theta is in which interval? 0 to pi by 2. So this is 0, this is pi by 2, right? And this is pi. 2 theta. So 2 theta belongs to which interval? Now the doubt comes. Which one I will take? 0 to pi by 2 or pi by 2 to pi? Because 2 theta is belonging to 0 to pi. So 0 to pi, there is 0 to pi by 2 one graph, pi by 2 to pi another graph. But where the derivative you need to find? At minus half. So for minus half, which value of minus half? X is minus half. So when x is minus half, what is theta? Tan inverse 3 power minus half, that is 1 by root 3, that is 30 degrees, pi by 6. Pi by 6 is in which quadrant? 0 to pi by 2. So based on the question, we need to decide which interval I have to take as far as derivatives are concerned, right? And what is the equation of this straight line? Y equal to x. So that's why it is 2 theta. So it is just 2 theta. But what is theta? Tan inverse 3 power x. So 2 tan inverse 3 power x. Now this is easy to differentiate. See, differentiating this function is little lengthy, because we need to differentiate this and we need to apply chain rule for this. But differentiation of this is very easy. So reason, see, we have f of x is now 2 tan inverse 3 power x. Tan inverse differentiation is 1 by 1 plus x square. Chain rule for 3 power x is 3 power x log 3. After that you substitute x is minus half. So the essence of this question is method. Method is important. Which method? Direct method, directly differentiating, which is brute force. There is a chance of making mistake. This is logical, conceptual. Once you know the graph, which theta you have to choose, and how you are choosing theta, based on this value, whatever is asked. Suppose the value asked is root 3 by 2, minus root 3 by 2. Minus root 3 by 2 means you substitute x is minus root 3 by 2. Suppose x is half, 3 power half is root 3, that is pi by 3. Still pi by 3 is in 0 to pi by 2. Again, I have to use this line only. So based on the information, we need to decide whether I have to use 0 to pi by 2 or pi by 2 to pi. Right? Thank you.